Hello and welcome to Business 2010 on CNBC Africa. I'm Angelo Coppola. On this episode of Business 2010, we take a look at the Travel Buddy, which will keep visitors, loved ones, back home in the loop of their whereabouts. We find out how important service excellence is in the tourism industry and not moving far from the sector. We also take a look at the Hospitality Youth Initiative. And as always, Dr. Nick joins us in the studio to talk press. Security is going to be a major issue come 2010. Andre Snyman has launched a concept that will keep tourists visiting South Africa safe and let their loved ones know exactly where they are to give them peace of mind.
In 2010, South Africa will play host to the greatest sporting spectacle ever seen on the African continent, attracting an estimated 3 million tourists. With this in mind, South African businessman Andre Snyman has capitalized on the influx of tourists and created a big brother or virtual bodyguard concept called Travel Buddy. The service aims to keep an eye on tourists while they travel through the country. However, Travel Buddy works on the backbone of another innovation of Andre's called eBlockWatch. eBlockWatch is an online network of South Africans who look out for one another and help those in need. It's been involved in some high-profile criminal and missing persons cases in South Africa.
eBlockWatch is a network of South Africans. Presently, we're 60,000 strong. We communicate via my communication system, which we've developed. It's basically a neighborhood watch, but it's a cyber neighborhood watch. We are connecting South Africans by email and SMS. And what we do is we're out there to look after every South African or tourist that is in this country. And the way we do that is we just create this massive database. We say, anybody who's got a problem, let me know. And then we mobilize that community to go and look after that person. So a lot of talk has happened about the crime in South Africa and this negative perception that there's a lot of crime. There is a lot of crime in South Africa, but I think we're getting to the stage where we're starting to manage crime. But I think the most important thing for a South African and a tourist is to know that you've got backing when you get into trouble or to somebody to tell you what to do, some streetwise advice. And with my members, they are scattered throughout South Africa. So I said to them, who would like to be a travel buddy? And I said, SMS the word TB back to this number, and I sent it out to my members. And within, I think it was a day or two, we had over 1,000 South Africans saying, yes, I will look after a tourist if he gets into trouble. Just send him to me. So I said, this is fantastic. So we created this network called Travel Buddy. So what do we do is Travel Buddy works off the backbone of eBlockWatch. eBlockWatch has got this incredible communication system. And we can zoom down to an area and notify these people in this area or in that industry of whatever we need to tell them. And so this is what we're doing with Travel Buddy. So what we're saying to the tourists is come and register on my website, Travel Buddy. Now is the trick. When I started this idea a couple of years ago, I was told, what the hell are you doing to the tourism industry? You are chasing tourists away. You're talking crime. But I'm not actually talking crime. So we divided this eBlockWatch. eBlockWatch is for South Africans and the neighborhood watch and the crime and the dirty laundry. And then you have Travel Buddy, which is all the nice, cushy stuff with nice South Africans on it and where the tourists can go and register. So there's no crime at all on that website. And all we do is we are prepared to mobilize good South Africans to look after any tourist that actually needs any assistance. It doesn't have to be crime. It can be anything. If a guy needs a dentist for his son and he happens to be in Nelspruit, I will mobilize that community, which I've done. I've got some fascinating stories about how we've actually looked after some tourists. I mean, the one that's quite amusing is there was an Indian guy, an Indian travel agent, and he arrived and he registered. And he pressed his button, because we give them little panic buttons on their cell phone, which locates their position and tells us that they need us. So we get this SMS that Mr. Patel needs some help. So we have a look on the computer and we see this guy's in Claremont. So I phone him up and I say, Mr. Patel, what's your problem? He says, I'm looking for a vegetarian pizza. So I said, no, well, we don't really do that, but let me see what I can do. So I looked at my daughter and I didn't have anybody in Claremont. So I zoomed out a bit and I saw right next door, in Hermanus, there was a woman that was under tourism, so I phoned her up and I told her my problem. She said, well, phone my friend. She's in charge of tourism in Claremont. So I phoned this woman, told her the same story. She said, okay, give me the guy's telephone number. So she phones Mr. Patel. She says, Mr. Patel, lift up your hand. He says, yeah. She says, just to the left. Over there, you'll find a vegetarian place. You can get your vegetarian pizzas there. So So he puts the phone down, he phones me, he says, Andre, where are you? So I said, I'm in Johannesburg. He said, who was that? I said, that's my travel buddy. Now that's an indication how we can mobilize right down to ground level, we can mobilize South Africans. They go to my website and they register. And once they register, all the details of how to register and what they have to do is on there. They basically connect their phones to my system. So wherever they go in South Africa, we will ping their phones three times a day. So they'll get it in the morning, lunchtime, and the evening. That will show on a map, which they've got a link to, that they can send to their family back home in Germany, in Düsseldorf. So in Düsseldorf, the family can actually sit there and monitor this guy's position and see Hans as he's going around South Africa. Now, when he gets to South Africa, he will get a number that he will dial. It's a speed dial number. So he presses the speed dial number. It's what we call our little travel buddy panic button. And an SMS will notify the travel buddies, which would be us, that we have a German in trouble. And we also have German South African expats, which we're pulling in. So these German expats, we have nominated a couple of German guys. There's one in Nelspruit, and there's one woman who's working at the Austrian embassy. She is the German coordinator. She will actually phone them and say, Jawohl, what's your problem? Wie geht's, whatever it is, and then make them feel at home. It's, oh, you've got a problem. You are in, say, Pietersfontein. That's when we'll go to our daughter. She'll contact us. We'll go to the daughter, and we will then mobilize all the people in Pietersfontein. But more than that, we'll mobilize all the Germans in Pietersfontein. And you can imagine how the Germans will react to one of their friends from Düsseldorf. They will have the best party you've ever seen. They'll have a beer fest every night. So this is what we're trying to do. We're trying to create this, like, great, exciting part of South Africa, introducing the tourists to communities. Not they don't have to get involved, but, I mean, this is a way that they can get involved, and in a controlled way.
The 2010 FIFA World Cup has allowed many entrepreneurs and innovators like Andre Snyman to use the event as a springboard for their ideas and business ventures.
I've been very fortunate that my idea has been coming for 8 years already. It was before 2010 was even here. But I think that it is, you know, a lot of people have good ideas, but without telling the people about the good ideas, it's like winking in the dark. Nobody knows about it. And that's the most difficult part of an idea. A lot of fantastic ideas out there, but to actually get them out is a very difficult thing. And what we do, Blockwatch does, is we take people with good ideas that want to help, and we put them out in our emails as little adverts for free to say to the guys, you know what, this is also a good idea. Here's another guy that's doing something fantastic, and I think as long as it's positive, we will promote it, and we will promote as many as we can. We are already promoting. So anybody out there that actually wants to get involved in something good, come to us. We will help, because we've got this huge amount of people out watching it, and we've got about 500 journalists on there as well. So this is a communication tool. It's kind of established, and we will help as many people as we can. And if we can get South Africans looking registered and looking after tourists like that, we'll be the friendliest country in the world. There is no other place in the world that can look after their tourists like that. I don't believe the police can do it on their own. I believe that if a tourist gets into trouble, we pull him in, sit him down, give him a Bronnewijn, contact us, we'll mobilize the right kind of people at the press of a button. And that tourist is going to go home, he's going to say, you know what? I had my bag snatched or something like that, but you can't believe what happened. These guys arrived there, they sat me down, they gave me a brandy, made some fantastic mates, had a braai, had the best time of my whole trip, and I'm back here in Brazil. You know, you can't believe how friendly South Africa is. If we can get that right, we're going to have a lovely time.